Hello everyone. Welcome to the 22nd video of the Adobe After Effects tutorial from beginner to advanced. In this video, I will teach you how to work with the graph editor. If you want to learn the After Effects software completely, please subscribe to my channel. The graph editor in After Effects shows the graph of the movement of an object over time, and we can improve the movement of the object by making changes in the graph. I have already prepared this project so that we can check how graph editor works. You can download this project below this video in the description section. If I press the play button, we can see that the ball moves in a straight path without changing the speed. I select the ball tool layer and press the letter U to reveal its keyframes. I select the keyframes of this layer. I right-click on one of the keyframes and select the Easy Ease option or press the F9 button. In this way, the shape of the keyframes changes, and if I press the play button, we can see that the speed of the ball changes over time. If you have been following my tutorials, you will remember that I have fully taught the Easy Ease options in lesson 10. With the K and J buttons, I put the time indicator on the keyframes, and it is clear that the balls reach the beginning and the end of the path at the same time, but the speed of the balls is different along the path. Now I reveal and select the third ball and press the letter U to see the keyframes of this layer. I select the keyframes of the third ball and activate the Easy Ease option by pressing the F9 button. Now I click on the graph editor option. When the graph editor is activated, you can see the graph of the selected keyframes. Note that if you forget to select keyframes, the graph editor will not display a graph. And if for any reason in the graph editor section, you cannot see the graph completely, activate the auto zoom option. In this case, by changing the size of the axis, the magnification is adjusted automatically. You can also zoom or move through time with the time navigator. First of all, you should know that there are two types of charts in After Effects, and by clicking on this option, we can choose the type of chart. The value graph, which is currently active for us, shows the value nodes, and the speed graph shows the speed nodes. In the rest of this video, you will understand them better when we work with charts. First, I select value graph. These yellow nodes on the diagram show the location of keyframes. If I place the time indicator on the node and click again on the graph editor, you can see that the time indicator is set precisely on the keyframe. The red curve shows the X value, which means the object's horizontal movement. The green line shows the Y value, the vertical movement of the object. The reason the Y axis is not curved is that we only change the X value for the ball. Actually, now the ball is only moving horizontally. Now, if I drag this node upwards, a curve will be created for the Y axis, and the ball's location will change on the Y axis. I hit Ctrl plus Z to go back. This time I select the X curve node and drag it to the left. At the same time, I hold the Shift key to move the node along a straight line. I place the node on frame 15. Actually, now the ball reaches the end of the path in frame 15 and returns again. As a result, the ball moves faster at the start and slower on the return. You can see that this keyframe is also placed in frame 15. Now, by holding the Shift button, I drag this node down or up. In this way, I can make the trajectory of the ball shorter or longer. Also, if we right-click on the desired node, we can change the value of X and Y by selecting the Edit Value option. By default, the unit of measurement in the graph is pixels, but through the Units option, it is also possible to change the unit of measurement to millimeters or inches. I return this node to 1 second. We can also edit the X and Y axis curves separately. To do this, click on the Separate Dimensions option or right-click on the position and select the Separate Dimensions option. Now I select the Y position option and place the time indicator in the appropriate frame. And I change the Y value of the position. In this way, we can create keyframes for the X and Y axes separately. This time I will select the X position, and for the handles to appear, I will select this node and click on the Easy Ease option. So now we can change the speed of the ball over time by moving and dragging the handles. Don't forget that you can access these levers in the value graph only when you have selected the Separate Dimensions option. I hit Ctrl plus Z to go back. This time I choose the Speed Graph option. As I said at the beginning of the video, the speed graph shows the graph of the object's movement, and we can edit the object's speed a little easier by using the handles. I set the node to 0 so that the ball starts moving slowly and reaches maximum speed over time. I repeat the same thing for the end node, so that the ball reaches the end of the path slowly. By changing the shape of the graph, the speed of the object also changes over time. I hit Ctrl plus Z to go back. Also, if needed, we can create a detailed diagram. To do this, I right-click on the node or the initial keyframe and select the keyframe velocity option. Since this keyframe we selected is at the beginning of the path, I will apply some changes to the outgoing velocity and increase the influence value to 75%. We can also change the speed value. I click OK and you can see the changes made in the chart. Now I will select the last node and right-click, and then select keyframe velocity. Because this time the keyframe we selected is at the end of the path, I apply the changes in the incoming velocity section and increase the influence value to 75%. In this way, I created a detailed diagram. So you can apply the changes you want by selecting any keyframe. At the bottom of the graph, you can choose how to display the graph. By selecting the Fit All Graph to View option, you can see the graph entirely. By using this option, you will see only the selected nodes. And by enabling the Auto Zoom option, you can enable automatic zoom. There are also other options for converting keyframes to linear and hold mode, which you learned about in Lesson 10. You can see the changes on the chart by converting the keyframes to linear and hold. We can also separate the middle nodes and determine their primary and secondary speed. In this case, the moving speed of the object slowly reaches the end of the path and starts moving again at high speed. When you need to see the speed and value graphs at the same time, enable the Show Reference Graph option. And by activating the Auto Select Graph Type option, the After Effect will select the graph you need automatically. Guys, if it's the first time you get to know the graph editor, it may seem a little complicated, but with practice, you can master it because working with the graph editor is very common and important in different projects. These two examples are the most widely used diagrams for creating animations in After Effects. Thank you very much for watching this tutorial till the end. Please like the video and leave a comment for me. Subscribe to see more tutorials. I see you next time.